Yeah, I get up.
Este amor llega a su estado de edad, no tiene la culpa. Y vaya una chivana, porque muy despreciado por el sol, no tiene la luna que va. Este amor llega a su estado de edad, no tiene la culpa. Amor te complementa, amor de el pasado.
silence. Who are we mistaken? But you see, it's not me, it's not my family.
That's all I can say. Wow. And I'm sure the audience are all picking up their jaws from the floor and putting them back up going, wow. That was just a wonderful, wonderful and obviously dramatically emotional for you guys as it was for us. It was just oozing over the footlights, I can tell you. Congratulations on an amazing piece of theatre. And how do you feel? I mean, how do you feel after that? Because I'm sure you've been rehearsing for many, many weeks and months to get to this point, and it was a huge crescendo. So, how are you feeling? You're okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Yeah, because I'm not. Honestly, it wasn't just the dramatic, everything, all aspects of it. The technique of the dance, the staging, and particularly I have to, and I know Scott will say all of this, but your onstage crew, you know, the set piece is moving and coordinating all of that and making sure that comes together. And I think, you know, that needs to be mentioned to all of the onstage crew for all the pieces tonight. Give them a round of applause because they truly do deserve a round of applause. So who do we have first? Is this...
Zoe.
Zoe. Beautiful Zoe. Now, Zoe... you okay?
Because
you must be exhausted.
Okay.
No, you must be exhausted after that routine. So I'm just filling in to allow you to catch your breath. There it is. You'll feel much better. So Zoe, can you tell us why you chose to do such an incredible story about such an incredibly wonderful artiste?
Okay, so our entry this year, entitled Guernica, inspired by Picasso's compelling 20th century anti-war protest artwork that tells the story of Nazi bombings in the Spanish Civil War. We intended to highlight the devastation of war as innocent civilians lost their lives tragically, but for what purpose? We wanted to bring light to the visceral and violent international tensions that highlight the actions occurring in the world today. Our story is one of history, but is it in the past?
Well done, Zoe. Thank you. Would you please thank Zoe? Would you like to hand your mic over to...
Olivia.
Olivia. Well done, Olivia. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling all right.
Yeah?
Got my breath back.
Good girl. Good girl. Can you tell us about how you use sustainability in the fabulous performance tonight?
Yeah. The sustainable practices that we've adopted to create our Wakakiri item this year includes the reuse of multiple costume pieces and props from previous years. For example, these skirts have been used from our past dance showcases. We've also reused the frameworks of our sets, which have been reused for the past 5 years. And the students also made the bullhorn headpieces out of cardboard and recycled fabrics.
Well done. Congratulations. Fantastic. Beautiful. Last but not least, Sophie. How are you feeling?
Yeah, pretty good.
Yeah? Fantastic. It really was. You should be all so proud of all the work. And I'm sure there is many, many people you would like to thank. Please.
Yeah. So firstly, I would like to thank our amazing crew, as you mentioned before. They are the backbone for this performance, and as you can tell, the set pieces are really a driving force for communicating our intention. Also, all of our dancers, for their commitment and their ability to empathise with others, has really brought this piece to life. Our teachers, our amazing teachers, Miss Skepa, Mrs. Drady, Mr. Futuris, Mr. Farmia, Miss Jess and Miss Tara. They have really worked tirelessly to piece this work together. Without them, this would not be possible. And finally, to the Wakakiri judges, the community involved, thank you for giving us the platform to be able to share this message and this story.